Hello, I'm Lara Soto with Texas Instruments High-Speed Amplifier Marketing Team. Today, I will demonstrate how to convert a Tina TI model into a generic SPICE model that is compatible with other popular simulators. In this example, I will be using the LMH5401 fully differential amplifier to show how to extract and save the netlist to be used in other simulators outside of the Tina TI program in just 5 easy steps. The 5 steps are to, first, get the Tina TI program, which can be downloaded for free at the following link. Second, the Tina TI model for the desired device must be obtained from the TI's website. Third, the device's macro model block must be extracted. Fourthly, the macro block will be used to obtain the netlist. Lastly, the circuit file must be saved, which can be imported into your favorite simulator. Now let's get started. Once Tina TI has been installed, search for the desired device on the TI website by going to ti.com and typing the part number in the search bar. Select on the devices page and proceed to the Tools and Software tab. In the Model section, select the Tina Reference Design Model and open the file in Tina TI. Once the schematic appears, right-click the macro block and select Enter Macro from the pop-up menu that appears. A netlist viewer window will pop up, which opens the SPICE netlist of the device's model. Proceed to the File menu and click on the Save As option. A window will appear that will prompt the user to save the netlist as a PSPICE circuit file, which is the .cir file. Once the file has been named and saved, it can be imported into any simulator that is compatible with .cir files to create a model of the TI device. For more information about Texas Instruments Tina TI program, please go to the following link. For technical support on the Tina TI program, please visit the following link. I hope that you have found this tutorial useful. Thanks for watching.